Hello everybody and welcome to the new Ruse Replaycast from the Panzerknacker. And today I got a replay from Speedfire's replay pack. In which he plays as German versus Asteroid as US American. Asteroid, I think he stopped playing about half a year ago, I think. And I have met him several times on a battlefield. Played with him, played against him in my noob time, I have to admit. So you won't see any good replays from me to this time. And I think he's a very good player. If Speedfire sends me this replay, he has to. And so what I have to say, I had cast this in German some minutes ago now, and I'm really flashed of this game. It was so crazy, so much things happened in this game, so many action, I can't show you all. All of the map was covered by units, it seemed, and yeah. If you didn't watch it in German yet, I hope you're gonna enjoy this version in English, for those who want to see English, because they don't really understand what I speak in German. And so let's start the game and begin with Speedfire's revision. And seems like he's beginning with a barracks and using decryption on Asteroid space, which is quite unuseful because he didn't even camo his space. And yeah, he actually sees that he go for depot and the barracks, so well, some kind of a waste, but like I always say, I just use decryption when the enemy camos his base, or maybe it's a Russian which is known as a rusher, and I want to know if he rushes or if he plays a mind trick on me and don't rush and goes for a macro start like those two do. Both of them go macro heavy opening with 40 posts and a barracks. Advantage for Speed is that he can produce the SD Kiev set 222 or 222, whatever. 222 is much shorter and sounds like a machine gun. And yeah, a grenadier to annoy Asteroid. Asteroid is trying to force Speedfire to produce or play with AT, because he's trying to, he deploys an armor, a decoy armor base in front of his base, I want to say. Yeah, that's what I want to say. But Speed, I think he sees what he's trying to do, and that's why he is he's not building any AT now, and because you can also see that it's a fake base. If you play with tanks, you want to produce them as fast as possible to make them get into combat and to make damage, and when there are no red lamps on the base, then like here in the barracks, you'll see that, yeah, it's a fake base. This is not always true. Sometimes you just wait a bit for attack or for money or for some things that you want to spend this money for, and so you have to be careful always and have to see if this is true. But it's also important that you see what you yourself up to next, and what you are planning to counter the infantry, maybe, or to make your next move. So Asteroid is spamming a lot of infantry around the map, and Speedfire is reacting with a lot of infantry also. And so Black and White mean a game, well, maybe next time. He wasn't in a mood to cast, so I cast this a couple of games alone, because we have to do some content, because in the last few days there wasn't much content on our channel because the connection with my internet provider from the StuNet was a bit fucked up. There his SDK set got encircled, but it came away. It could flew from the battles. Well, I used blitz on them, so they can flew easier, yeah, something like that. Well, his SDK set, maybe, yeah, he didn't lost his SDK set, but he lost 4 infantrists, which has pretty the same, or which cost pretty the same. What he's trying to do here. So, speed sees that he's trying to do another move on placing, producing, building another building here. Rangers destroyed. Ah, yeah. So, both flanks are cleaned now, and he can contest. Well, the map control von Asteroid was contested, and this Ranger goes the long way, the long run. Also, he is contested in mid. Asteroid has more infantrists there, and also got now the first full arena out. I think you want to make a move versus the SDK sets and rest. You want to grow up his economy here. He's trying to, yeah, to build up his 6th depot. While Asteroid is still on 4, I think he's building his. No, not even. There comes the truck. It's 5th depot now. And. Yeah. Because it's a really commitment to go on AT now. Speedfire actually just need to continue with building infantrists and watch carefully on his SDK sets. And so his AT can't do that much damage. So a good move from him is now that he plays with artillery. He already got 3 out. Wow. He's also committing heavy on artillery now. But it's really good move because they are supporting the infantrists of Speedfire really well. Ooh. Watch this Ranger. They are shooting. Infantrists are rooting. That's right. Damn. MC Panzerschach in the house, bitches. Watch Ranger shooting, artillery is rooting. Ach du Kacke. Serious business shit or whatever. Ooh, the SDK set got heavy shots from the AT gun here. But I think the. Here. Would be, he lost the depot. Yeah, why? I don't think that the Ranger got another grenade out of his pocket, so. Maybe the artillery did damage, the final damage to this depot. Is he losing another depot now? But they have the same amount of depots here. I think Asteroid don't want Speed to gain a great economy to produce his really strong units as a German. And yeah, he's trying to flank him on every side, trying to make a tech move, trying to attack him when he's off guard. And seems like this happened here, cause he get one depot down, which is not really not good for him, cause this was a misinvestment, I think. Yes, it was a bad thing for Speedfire, but. I have to contest or to defend this one. Okay. This is defended very well. Cause, yeah. 4 SDK set and 3 Storm Grenadiers. And also artillery firing on his infantrists. This really gets hard for Asteroid. sorry for coughing, or if I sound a bit like I have a cold, cause I have one. And yeah, ooh, good move from Asteroid. Now he's building the first bombers, And it's a really good move versus the light units of Speedfire. And they're also blobbed here, which can Zone can deal pretty good damage here. But he also got his first AA guns out, so no problems actually. And he's also using terror or terrorism, what it's called, terror on his own base. A pretty good ruse when the bombers come, because pretty good ruse, because they root after some couple of shots from the AA before they can drop their first bomb. But this move could be denied when they or when he is using fanatism. Sorry, I'm in game, dude. Despe. Sorry. He's trying this to attack this depot. Is he using any camo or there's a really this won't be useful anyway. He's losing the next depot now. This is at the moment really not good for speed. This Wolverine anti-M157mm is keeping his SDKF set away from the depots, deny him the what's called the depot, the supply. Not a depot, the supply. Right. And good thing for him is that he can reproduce his infantries and produce them faster and get him faster at the battlefield or at their combat zone, because he deployed the barracks at this side here, so you can better defend this depots. And let's see what is now in the map. What was this? I think it was a bully. So now Speedfire Ultimate, same move like Asteroid, with the difference that he's building the untacked fighters from the German. Ooh, he's dividing or splitting his infs to avoid too much damage from the bombers. I think four or three infantrists died there anyway, but he got one bomber though, and I think the trade was even for Asteroid. And I would say that Speedfire now got the upper hand at the unit tech. I think he got a really high count of artilleries. Maybe he lost one there. A bad thing for him if five Rangers are pushing through their lines, the artillery can't shoot that quick or route. So the Wolverine here is out of use, I think. Can't do anything versus the infantrists, maybe versus the SDKF set. But it's I think it's protected very well with the infantrists. Now also a really good move from Asteroid. He's he built and tagged the Sherman tank. This can be very hurtful for Speedfire now, cause he didn't have any, there it comes, the AT base. But he didn't get any AT on the way now. You have to tag first the AT guns, cause the light AT gun 36, I think, doesn't deal that much damage. Just using Blitz now, I think you want to. This can be very hurtful now for him. Hey, one Stone Grenadier, get Sherman. Lucky move from him. But he's really contesting and attacking at the base or in front of the base from Speedfire now. Out of a Stuka. Focus the Wolverine out of the out of the unit composition. Really good move from him. So his Marder can attack better. But this was mistargeted. And I think the Sherman. This is really I think this push is denied again from Asteroid. He made his damage, one barracks, a couple of units, I think. Whoa, but as you can see, he didn't make that much points. I hope he can attack the depot here. With 9 supply trucks or $9 remaining. Yeah. And the Sherman gets down and the M16 got destroyed here. Oh, bad move from Asteroid. He lost his... oh no, he got one AA here. He lost his front AA here. So it is 2 cars and the MA can attack now easily. Really good from him. And... nein. So now, but the Sherman are still on the field. He is producing some more of them and also some Bofors. A really good composition though, but he can't attack further because Speed's protecting his base very well with the mortars and the infantry and also with his artillery. It's gonna be very harsh for him to push through Speed's alliance now. Maybe he lost a couple of units here, but it's also, or it can be a trap to attack in this direction when there's a barracks and here are infantrists. They can encircle you and then your tanks are all gone. Especially when they are less maneuverable like King Tigers or IRL 44. Ooh, good move here from Asteroid. I don't think if this was intended, but he's distracting and denying the AT to protect the infantrists or this side from the Shermans. He's using his infantrists very well then in this situation. But yeah, I think he got a lot of stone grenadiers here at Speedfire, so he can hold off this push until the mortars arrive. And what's up here? Ah, he's trying to destroy the Williad. So it can't... Oh, no, he's not trying to destroy it because it's hidden. Well... What he's trying to do now? Well, Speed, what's your plan? What's your plan? Oh, now you have to be careful because... Asteroid tech the M5 67mm, and which can one hit the mortar, and he has to be pretty careful with his mortars now. But his mortars are really central, so he can protect them with his infantrists, which are at the flanks. Really good tactical maneuver from him, though. So the Storm Grenadiers can attack the AT, or even like you see, Armoron easily gets shot by the M5. I think he wanted to destroy or deny the supply from this depot, but the infantrists and the M5 denied this little push. Yeah, Stukas versus 3 Bofors and an M16. Not gonna happen. There it goes, and boom. Yeah, chasing some willies. It's like a dog catching his tail. We'll never reach them because they're always faster. And they're really fast. I think 47 kilometers per hour. And he's trying to push now on this side with Shermans and infantry. Got no AT. Ah, there comes the AT. But he has to be careful. If he's losing too much of these infantrists, the infantrists of Asteroid can distract the mortars from attacking the Shermans. And the Shermans can contest this depot here. It's also be Speed's also contested on this side, in the mid, with infantrists. But good thing for him is that his artillery is shooting on this depot here. Only 27mm. Not 27 millimeters, $27 are remaining, and he gets it down. Really good move from him. So, he is on. Asteroid is on one depot now, but I think, Speedfire is 2 on 1, also on 1 depot. And the Shrooms are also raging. And oh yeah, I think he got some of the Marauders here, cause they had to turn around in this area, and the Rangers got them in bazooka range. Really hurtful for Speedfire, but I think. Oh, and also what's happened here? Yeah, like what I said, always action there in this game, and area action. Really crazy game. He destroyed the artilleries in this area, cause they can't move through the forests like the AA guns. Ooh. He also got Pak 40 mm, Pak 40. I think it's really useful against the Hulies, like you see. There he got a bitch slap, and yeah, can surprise attack the Rangers really good. But you have to be careful, because some of the Rangers are pushing through here. And yeah, also Wolverine can get shot easily by Pak 40. You have to be careful, you have to send some infantrists. But the thing famous that this barracks is a bit out of the M5 can attack the Marauders in some seconds. No, oh, it gets shot before it can hit on the Marauder. And also he can defend with this little Ranger push here. Ooh, he's pushing out with his Pak 40. No, ah, it stays alive. Lucky Speedfire would. Oh, it gets destroyed, I think, by the last grenade of this Hero Ranger, or of this Hero Ranger. The Shermans tried to take a backdoors into. Oh! Nice shot. Two Marauders had each one another target and one shot at the Shermans. It's like synchrone shooting or something. We have to be careful. There are infantry pushing through the city covering and trying. Oh, this can be a crucial damage for. Whoa, also the bomber is. Oh, lucky Speedfire! Lucky, lucky Speedfire! This Stuka here ported back at the end of the airfield when the bomber. When the bomber drops his bombs. So now we have to. Have to keep his air or his air force in the air, cause there are Rangers waiting for the airplanes at the ground, and also the Shermans are taking shots at the airfield. Well, I think he spent way too much infantrists, but you have to be sure. It's yeah, when you have to act at all fronts, it's really not that easy to micro all units. Everybody makes faults, but this wasn't, I think, in this case, this doesn't really matter, cause he didn't lost, I think he didn't lost any of his storm grenadiers, so I have to be careful now, because the M16 is, well, he's creating the airfields right when they take off from the airfield. And getting them some, yeah. Oh, what's Bly in English? Plumbum? Don't know. And yeah, I think he has to put down the M16 first. And he has to be also careful, cause there are also some infantry pushing through again. But seen from the unit count now, Speedfire got more units than Asteroid. And they both have no depots and still 2 minutes left. It's gonna be a hard game at the end. I think he can get a couple of points here, destroying the Bofors and the Rangers. I have to be quick until the reinforcement and the Sherman arrives. Nice artillery, I think, yeah, 3 of them are left from 7 or more. And even his flak is. I say A guns are were destroyed. Yeah. He has to retreat now, cause the Sherman is arriving and reinforcement from the Rangers. Yeah, 45, well, 54. I'm gonna be a waste if he rebuild these depots, because there are just, well, 130 left. He should spend his last money into units. His Germans got shots from the side, but the Rangers are advancing forward to attack or to distract the Marder and keep them off from the Sherman. You have to pull it back quickly. Yeah, there it goes. He's even trying to destroy the Rangers with the mace, but bad trade for him. He lost two mace for one Ranger. So Asteroid is now in front of points. But even though, this is gonna be a draw, because I think just win if you got 10% more points than the enemy, or 30 or 10, I don't know. So I think he has to make more than 100 points now in 28 seconds, which could be pretty impossible. If he don't take or capture his HQ or maybe some other bases, or get an atomic bomb on some units here. He's trying to make some points, even though if there aren't any opportunities, and then the game is your team wins. What the fuck? I thought it was a draw. What doesn't exceed 10% of the enemy score? Well, in the German version, you will see that this game was a draw. Anyway, your team wins. Which team was I? Ah, I was Camp Neutral. Okay. I won the game, but also really, really great game from Speedfire and Asteroid. Special thanks to him for this replay and for the other one. And yeah, if you also got great replays, you want to that we show commentate for you, feel free to send them at the email in the info text. And yeah, if you like this video, push the green thumbs up button and commentate in a comment section below. And yeah, feel free to subscribe, and if you are a subscriber at the moment, it would be very cool from you if you support us by saying anyone you know what we do on our channel here. So thanks for watching, and see you next time.